España, y donde Franco.
Nå du dansk, Lone, but because your book is out in English beside Norwegian and Swedish, we can speak English.
Also because Danish is such a, you know, difficult language.
It's impossible to understand. And we can use him as an excuse.
Right.
So, this, so thank you for being
My
here.
My pleasure, thank you.
You are a neurobiologist and a science writer, and,
right.
and you wanted to map your own genes.
Right.
Why?
Why? It's a good question. Well, I was in a very strange situation. It was a couple of years ago, and my father died. And speaking about father figures, he was a huge figure in my life. Mm. He was the one who brought me up, really. And he was my only family because my mother died when I was 18. So suddenly there I was. I have no children, so, and no parents, so I felt like suspended in midair. And I wanted to sort of, suddenly I felt the urge to connect with my, you know, heritage. And then being a biologist, I mean, a normal person would probably have gone to, you know, church records and studied the, you know, the history of the family. I, of course, wanted to study my genes to see who I was.
But how do you do it practically? How does it happen?
Well, very easy, in fact. You go onto the web, you click on send me a test kit, please. It's a little letter, and there is a little sort of, you know, like a Q-tip. And you scrape the inside of your mouth, you get a few cells with DNA, you send it back to the company, and you wait for a week or two.
What were your greatest fears? Before you got the result.
Yeah. Well, the thing is that you get to know about, you know, your personal disease risk for a variety of diseases, like 50 or 60, depending on the company. And once you sit there and your results are, you know, available on the web, you start to think about your family history. And some of the first memories I have from when I was 3 or 4 was my grandmother, my mother's mother, dying of breast cancer. So I've always had it in the back of my mind, like,
so this
I'm
was
probably
what
gonna
you were
get this.
Sort of thinking about when, while you were waiting for the mailman to come deliver the verdict.
Well, it's not even the mailman anymore. I mean, we live in modern times. It's over the web. So, so you have... You know.
I'm just like the record company man, you know?
Yeah. I mean, you have a message in your inbox saying, Lone Frank, your genome profile is now ready. Click here.
Yeah. I didn't understand that part, though, because I actually did this test.
So, you did it as well?
Yeah, I did. But I went online and I clicked refresh like a couple of times every day, and I was like, why isn't it instant there? And obviously, it took like a couple of weeks before the result.
They actually have to process all this stuff.
Yeah. I missed that part.
So what did you learn?
I learned an awful lot, but what I was most interested in, and we haven't even covered this, was not really these, you know, physical diseases. What I was most driven by was also learning about, you know, why do I have the psychology I have? Because I come from a family that is, you know, ridden with depression. Every generation has its depressive people and its suicides, you know, people who've hung themselves, shot themselves. My mother was really, really depressive. My father was bipolar, so he got both the downs and the ups. And I'm depressive myself. So I was wondering, I wanted to see, you know, is this just, you know, upbringing or environment or what is in the genes here? So that, I think, was the most interesting part of the whole thing.
What's the answer?
Well, the answer is that, you know, there is a little group of genes, like a handful of them, where we know they play a part in your psychological makeup. Say how you, you know, how well you deal with stress, how sensitive you are, how you know, your risk of depression, anxiety, that kind of you know, that area. And that little handful of genes, they all exist in like two variants, a sensitive variant that makes you more disposed to depression, anxiety, not dealing well with stress. And then the sort of more robust variant. And it turned out I was sitting actually in front of a professor who did these tests for me. When she came up with, you know, ticked off one gene after another, and I had this sensitive variant for all of them. So it felt like, you know, I just lost the genetic lottery. You know, in a way, it was like, oh God, I can understand why, you know, I feel depressed once in a while. So that was interesting, I think.
Would you like to know?
I'm more interested in whether or not it gives you any indication of lineage, because I have a missing grandparent.
Right.
And I would love to home in on my grandfather, who was never spoken of, on pain of terrible rage from my grandmother, right, to her daughter and to everybody. He had no name. He had no place. I believe that he was a Russian Jewish emigre who was in the United Kingdom in about 1913, 14. And I would love to find out in my DNA if it's at all possible.
Is this your paternal or maternal?
This is a quarter of my genes.
Yeah, but is it your maternal or paternal grandfather?
Maternal.
Maternal.
Yeah.
That would be difficult because you would have to test, you know, the Y chromosome to see, you know, where is that on the lineage.
So it's the church records, I'm afraid.
Probably is. Yeah. If he has any male descendants, you know, in a direct line, if you could get their Y chromosome, you could probably get an answer.
No, my mother was an only child.
Yeah.
Because he disappeared.
Yeah. So. Yeah. Church records for you.
In Odessa, probably.
Right, yeah. Good luck. Yeah.
What are we supposed to do with the information? It might stress us. It might make us more depressed. I mean, it's...
Well, now you're talking like a bioethicist.